When a device comes into our laboratory, it's important to know what happened by asking the customer. This information provided by the customer is key to reduce the time of the repair. For example, the customer might indicate us that the device does not turn on after a shock. In this case, to start the diagnosis, it's necessary to look for fractures in the motherboard or in any integrated circuit. Another situation could be that the customer says that the device got wet in the swimming pool. In this case, it's necessary to find the water damage areas and try to solve the problem. Another possibility is that the customer has left the device on the bedside table at night and in the morning it does not turn on. This can be due to a problem with the CPU, memory, or any power circuit that has stopped working. Finally, the customer might indicate us that after a shock, the rear camera, the speaker, or microphone doesn't work. This can be because the camera is internally broken, or the circuit that supplies power to the camera is damaged, or the motherboard is having some internal fracture that prevents voltage or data from being sent to the camera, microphone, or the speaker. Therefore, this step is one of the most important when we are starting our diagnosis. Before performing an analysis of a mobile device, it's necessary to know its power source and understand the types of consumption that can occur when the device has a failure, such as when the customer says that the device runs out quickly, or when the battery has been changed and the device still has the same problem, or after a fall the device is dead. Therefore, it is essential to know and understand the power on cycle to perform a good analysis. To perform an adequate analysis, it is necessary to know and understand the schematic plans. Fortunately, there are paid tools and some ones for free, like ZXW, DZKG tools, WuXinji, mobile1tech.com, EasyDraw, Borneo are tools that facilitate our work. These tools provide a variety of schematics and diagnoses. However, in some models of multiple brands, we might find some problems finding schematics. Therefore, it's necessary to resort to logic and experience and to be able to make a good analysis for these devices. This course is all about this, like identifying a failure easily. DZKG Tools is a paid tool that works with many brands and models of mobile devices, such as Apple, Samsung, Huawei, Xiaomi, among others. This tool offers different type of payments, including the possibility of acquiring it at a reduced price if it's shared with three colleagues. The price that can came out is laughable. One of the most interesting features of DZKJ is the layout section, which is very similar with the ZXW tool. This allows the user to see the location of the component and where each line goes. In addition, this section also offers information on the function of each component, and on the right it opens the schematic plan. It is important to note that, although there is a large number of free schematics on the internet, the purchase of these paid tools is becoming increasingly necessary to perform an effective diagnosis. These free schematics can be found on Google, however it takes some time to find them. Therefore, it's advisable to have a budget for the purchase of paid tools. So, there are no excuses for not having a quality mobile repair tool. With DZKG tools, you will have a lot of models necessary to solve any repair problem you might find in your laboratory.